Hey guys, welcome back to another episode. Hope you are doing really good and enjoying your quarantine or learning something new every day. So today we're going to talk about another book review, which is Pilgrim Nation by Devdutt Pattanaik. So before that, I read a couple of books by the Devdutt Pattanaik, which like he have written more than say more books, but out of that I have read Jaya, which is based on the Mahabharata, Sita, which is based on the Ramayana, and Devlok with Devdutt Pattanaik, where he answers a lot of questions about the mythology and different aspects. So when I read Pilgrim Nation, which is recently launched, I kind of have doubts. I'm not completely agree with this book, but still we're gonna deep dive into what is a Pilgrim Nation and how he divided everything. So Pilgrim Nation is like making of Bharatvarsh. He has like 32 pilgrims all over the India. Like if you consider where you can see the screenshot here, that how the nation is divided into the different pilgrim. So like he talk about what are the pilgrims, how they are interconnected, before we have states, before we have everything, how the sun and the other people, how we used to travel to find their gods, and different crossing the rivers and boundaries, not caring about anything, just meeting for the god. While making the pilgrims, he has like divided into different categories, total 8 categories. He talk a lot, and again that 8 categories divided into subcategories, which talk about the specific city or the specific where the conflict happened or where the really god exists. Or right now if you consider the Kolhapur, Kolkata, Bombay, so these are the places where the pilgrim happened. So he divided the timeline into different parts, from aging from the 3000 years back to the current stage. So this is how he divided the pilgrim into different sector. And out of that, the first one is which always he talk about the Vedic section, the Islamic section, Tantric section, British section, the Puranic section, and the present section. These are the categories out of that which he talk about in this book. And then again, these categories are divided into subcategory, where he very exactly took you to the details of how the journey of the pilgrim begins, or how that you should cover the journey of pilgrims. There are total 32 pilgrims. Out of that, first pilgrim, which is the Vedic. In the Vedic pilgrim, which is 3000 years back, he talk about the Varanasi, Saundati, Manali. I mean, these are the cities where the pilgrim happened. So I believe like this pilgrim is a kind of a personal journey for the Devdutt, because we are ready to relate to that, but kind of somewhere find that okay, this is some misconceptions, or he always find there is some conflict between two religions or the two different sectors. So that's why I don't understand why he did this. The second one, which is a talk about, is the Sharman. The second divided section is the Sharman pilgrim, where he talk about like in that section he talk about the Shravanbhago and Rankapura, where is 2500 years ago. Then it's like we are moving from the 3000 years to 2000 years ago. Then it's like we are moving in the timeline to get into the present. In the third section, he talk about the Puranic, in that he added the Kolhapur, Ujjain, and this kind of where I have been and I can relate to this. These are like 1000 years old, but I don't understand the information is wrong. I mean, it's not exactly what I know from the Kolhapur. I mean, I have been to the Kolhapur. I have been Kolhapur for my life has spent almost in the Kolhapur. So I know he don't understand the difference between the Lakshmi and the Mahalakshmi, or the reason why there is a Mahalakshmi. I mean, there is a temple of the Mahalakshmi. What is the history behind that Mahalakshmi? And what he wrote in this book is like a conflict to me. And probably if you have read this book, you will understand that the difference, that what you know as a Mahalakshmi and what he talk about in this book. So I don't understand why this kind of conflict happened, because if we have deep down knowledge about a little bit of mythology, we will understand this better. After that, he talk about the Tantric age, Islamic age, Bhakti age, European age. Like this, we are moving from the 1000 years ago to 800 years ago to 400 years ago. This is how we are moving in the timeline. But like after that, he have added the Delhi, Amritsar, Kolkata. I'm not going to give you each and every detail that what exactly that pilgrim is and what is the reason behind that pilgrim. because for me it's kind of for Devdutt, for its kind of self journey, I mean it's kind of a self journey or the self realization of that pilgrim. But this is how we talk about this pilgrim, different pilgrim, and he, like, it's after that he ended in the native place, which is like the present state, which is in the Mumbai. Like, I have no idea about that. Out of that 72 pilgrim, I have visited like couple of pilgrims, but what I know and what I am reading this book is a kind of conflict for me. If you want to understand what are those nation pilgrims, I will highly suggest you to read this book. And do let me know what you think about pilgrim. If you have been or if you are living in any of this city, you will understand that you obviously know the history behind that pilgrim, and you can able to relate that whether whatever you are reading in this book is right or wrong. The sum point of this book is really good. You will understand much better. But there are few points that I completely disagree, or maybe my knowledge is lying, or maybe what I know, what I've read from the past years, maybe that's a different. Because if you know that tantric age is not was a pan India, that was on the limited section of India. Then if you talk about the Kolhapur, where he don't understand the difference between the Lakshmi and Mahalakshmi, then we talk about the Islamic age and the Bhakti age, that probably happen on the same kind of a timeline, but he mentioned in this different sector. So like, there are some good points, there are some bad points, but if you want to understand what are the nation pilgrims, then I will definitely recommend this book, because Devdutt have some good knowledge about the mythology, and if we get out of that conflict situation, then he can deliver of the best out of the best value. So this is what all about the nation pilgrim, the making of Bharatvarsha. I'm talking about the 32 pilgrim. I'm going to visit this 32 pilgrim, which is very soon, not today, but in future I'm going to visit that. By this I will understood what is exactly the situation behind that. But right now this book is like for me 50-50%, not 100% sure about it. After when I able to understand, then I can talk about it for sure. So don't forget to check out the quotes at the end of this video. See you in the next video. If you want me to review any of the book, then do let me know in the comment. Don't forget to follow me on the Instagram, where I post detailed reviews, quotes and a lot of string and learning. See you in the next one.